In half a mile, turn left onto Woodbine.
Outside to, but if you do, you better win, you better show the dominate. You can't do that, and they go out and lose by 39. top gifts for preteens, teens. And by the way, congratulations. I know it's not public, but congratulations to Kenny and his girlfriend. They are expecting. What a blessing.
Stop it.
It finally happened.
What a blessing.
This child is a blessing to the both of us.
Wow.
Oh God, please be joking.
I'm totally kidding.
The girls in Mexico. Oh my God, my face turned pink.
One here. My kids got this last year. They both had this. It's $49.99 at Amazon. It's a little mini fridge. So it holds maybe like two cans of pop, or like girls can put their like creams and their lotions and stuff. But it keeps pretty cold.
Wait, the refrigerator in the kitchen is not enough.
Well, they don't leave their rooms. The kids don't leave their rooms anymore. So this is a way to keep their...
I'm going to let David go first. And Roberto, you have children. I'll offer you my take in a pretend world where I ruined my life by having it.
$50 on a fridge that fits two cans of pop. Why waste your money on that?
Right.
No need.
Also,
welcome to the other world.
My parents are waiting on that brownie from the Easy Bake Oven light bulb.
Also, why are you enabling your kids to not leave their room?
There it is.
That's a problem,
there it
right?
is. My parents would never allow it. Did you even have TV in your room?
No.
That's not allowed.
Really?
TV's in the common areas only.
Wow.
I had a TV.
Wow, really?
Yeah, I know. God forbid we had some discipline in our home.
Yeah.
Next.
I mean, I can't relate.
I had a TV in the bathroom. I had a TV in the tanning room. I had a
Leave this guy who grew up in Scarface's house.
Okay, how about now? I like this one. Actually, this could be for maybe Kenny would like this, but certainly this is cool for kids. It's like the top 100 movie scratch-off poster. So you get this poster with all the cult favorite movies and classics and even some newer releases that literally everybody should see. And every time you see one, you kind of scratch off the list.
You know what? I've actually seen something very similar to this, Roberto. It was a calendar. You can binge watch it.
I like that.
That tells you what to binge watch.
But what kid? Kids don't even watch movies.
Can we get this for Mike with the Avenger movies?
Yeah.
Just a schedule, a regimented.
It would take a lifetime to complete that.
He's got a week coming up, and I know he's not going to watch any. I've given that up. You know what, Mike? Just go ahead and watch the final two movies. You won't know what's happening, but at least you'll get to see Purple Grimace, as you call him.
Purple Grimace. Next. All right, now this item comes from our childhood, and now it's making a big comeback. Kids want this, apparently, nowadays. Like the sort of the Polaroid camera, but this one Kodak makes where it's an instant camera. The picture comes out, and it actually has like a sticky back that you can, you know, put up in your locker or your room, whatever the case.
A phone or a tablet.
Yeah, no, I am amazed. It's just like vinyl records. They want to go back. They want the old school stuff.
Because you can now take the picture. Like, if you have it on your phone, that's one thing, but now you can put it up on the wall or wherever. So, yeah, I can see where that's coming back. Because if not, you got to go and get it printed out from your phone.
Take a slight right turn to merge onto M10 North.
If you think about it, David, my like entire childhood is in like 10 photos.
You're right about that.
And now it's like kids have 10 photos. That was just a trip to Meijer.
Yeah, now the kids have every single day of their life is documented.
Yes,
that's so right about that.
It's like I found a photo. It was like me and my sister and Spider-Man. And it was like, oh my God. Yeah. I remember this day.
I'm young nieces and nephews, this stuff has not been asked for. These are some weird gift ideas. Plus, I wouldn't do it. I would not be the adult buying a two-can pop fridge.
It's not happening.
It's not happening.
I'm the idiot that does.
Right, well, you're a moron. And I think it was chargeable. Like, you could, like, USB charge it, and then it would have, like, 2-3 hours of charge time. But
is it the fridge?
Yeah. I swear to God,
okay, that's
kids,
just a waste of money.
Use the right lane to take a slight right turn to merge onto M10 North toward I-696 West.
You never say no to your kids. They ask for the most outrageous stuff, and you do it.
Can we have some old school crack?
Right.
Now, how about,
I want the Nino Brown crack.
The Rock.
Man, take a slight right turn.
Let me see what I can do on that.
Whatever you kids want, I'll make it.
Now, I don't know how you guys...
I was looking up a photo. I saw this woman that I might want.
Oh,
is this my real daddy?
Oh, this one. This scrub retails for $108. I don't know if you guys are into this or not. Are you guys into the weighted blankets?
Yes.
Okay.
But no kid deserves a weighted blanket. That's an adult.
That's $108.
That's ridiculous.
You ruined it so fast. That's such a bad idea.
That's a horrible idea for a child.
Turn right on Tankster Road.
Is the weighted blanket that great? It's fabulous.
Really?
Is it as weighted like an endorsement for the purple bag?
Stay on the right.
They're great. You want one for Christmas?
My God.
Rico.
It's
like the black angel of death is hugging you to sleep.
Wow.
But I wouldn't get it for a kid. I'm with Kenny. Kids ruin everything, including your life.
Don't ruin your life, Mike.
Now, how about this? $90 retail. They're all white. They go with everything and anything. The Nike Air Force Ones. Very classic. Yeah, classic and never go out of style.
No, they're not bad. They're not bad. I still wear them because I used to wear them back in the day, but no, they're not bad.
Oh, really?
What do you mean, old Frito? That's what I grew up with, so I still wear them.
Well, here's another thing that you've been trying to get this to come back, too. Now, I know you wear them as fanny packs.
Those are back, and I refuse to.
I see Rico as being a guy that once had a
stay
fanny
in the left pack. Three lanes.
Yes.
Never had a fanny.
Wow, I can't believe it.
Oh, I can't believe I'm wrong on that.
Never had a fanny bag, but as Mike, what did you call it? What do I tailgate with?
Oh, you have a man bag.
Man bag.
Because it's not a backpack, but it's not a handbag. It's a man bag. And Rico rolls in. He's like, he's got his man bag. No one ever knows what's in it. But stops in, pumps a few mitts, kisses a few babies, makes a plate, and then the man bag is gone. In the distance.
Well, I know Rico loves these. He probably has this in his man bag. He retails for $50. The Hydro Flask water bottle. I know Rico loves these. It keeps the ice in there, keeps everything cold. And the Hydro Flask is the ultimate.
Why would a kid need that? What children are you showing
in school? In school, they need a water bottle.
No, you don't. You go to the water fountain.
At the light, turn right onto Inkster Road.
Kids walking around with Yetis at school. What the hell is
they
this?
They do. They all got it.
Now, the Hydro Flask is great. I mean, ice stays in that thing for ever. It's loaded up. But, yeah, for a kid, you can't go to the drinking fountain?
Yeah. Do you really want to drink out of a drinking fountain
these days? 1.4 miles, turn left onto West 14 Mile Road.
They need one.
Drinking fountains are disgusting.
Yes, they are.
I don't know. We survived.
I know. We also drank out of the water hose in the backyard.
What's wrong with that?
No, I said we also did. That was water, right? You want some water?
That's the best water tonight.
You and your friends are over. Hey, Ma, can we have some water? The water hose.
Playing basketball in the street.
Right. Just let it run for 30 seconds.
Can I be honest with you? You know, I've been doing like the last month or so. I've been so lazy that you can set your watch to it that I have to get up and go number one a lot during the night. And what I've been doing is I'm too lazy to go into the kitchen. I'll just put my mouth under the sink and let the cold water just go right into my mouth.
In the bathroom?
Man, I thought we were headed for an empty
bathroom. I really was like, well, I'm sure you can use what I just said against me in some sort of bit.
Nope. No, we won't. All right, give us the last gift. These are not children's gifts in my world.
Now, this one could have cost you maybe a couple $100. But this one I've been trying to get Mike into for years, and the kids want it. Vinyl is bigger than it's ever been. It's the biggest selling music format in the world. The Bluetooth record player. It's a good way to get the teens started. Give them the gift of vinyl.
Yeah. So your kid can
Rico
destroy
agrees with me.
Rico, do you agree? Any nieces, nephews getting this as a gift?
No.
What kid actually wants vinyl?
At the next stop sign,
what kind of hipster freakazoid child are you raising?
He actually works in music, and he
like some kid is sitting out in Lapeer going, "Yes, I want to get Boz Skaggs on vinyl, please, Santa."
Who?
Can I get Kanye's College Dropout?
Right. Reissued
vinyl.
Now,
Dad.
Everything's reissued and available now. Everything.
Straight out of Compton.
That's vinyl.
There it is. All day long. You can get it at Walmart.
LL Cool J's Radio.
Nice.
Another tremendous gift-giving guy.
At the stop sign, turn left onto West 14 Mile Road, then turn right onto Easter Road.
BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks, welcomes you to the lock of the year. Simply place a $10 moneyline wager on either Los Angeles or Arizona, and if either team scores a touchdown, and let's face it, they will, you'll win $200 in free bets regardless of your bet's outcome. Just use bonus code RICO200 when you make your first bet. Enjoy football like never before with BetMGM's live betting options, the boosted odds specials all season long. Download the app or go to BetMGM.com. Use bonus code RICO200, RICO200, to win $200 in free bets in either Los Angeles or Arizona scores a touchdown. They're giving away money, folks. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. You must be 21 years or older to wager, Michigan only. New customer offer. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable free bets or site credits. Free bets expire 7 days from being issued. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-270-7117 for confidential help. Excludes Michigan disassociated person.
97.1 The Ticket. Traffic.
Currently with WWJ AM 950 Traffic Center. This report brought to you by Fort Bishop Airport. Traffic signals are not working correctly at the intersection of Telegraph and 5 Mile Finkel, so seeing some delays in both directions. Also, slowdowns on 94 eastbound from 8 to 10 mile due to construction that's blocking the left lane. Hitch a ride to the Orange Bowl in Miami with Flint Bishop. Support your Wolverines and make a vacation out of it. Get your nonstop flight from FNT to Fort Lauderdale, Miami before flights fill up. Book online only at Allegiant.com. I'm Michelle Pena with traffic.
Ho, ho, ho. Everyone knows that Kris Kringle is the Santa of the North Pole, but here in Michigan, Mother Waddles plays the role of Santa to thousands of needy families year-round. In fact, Mother Waddles has been helping the poorest of the poor for over 60 years. And now you can become one of Mother Waddles' elves by donating your car today. But time is running out. You must donate your car before December 31st if you want that year-end Blue Book value tax deduction as a stocking stuffer. So if you have an extra car and you're considering donating it, call Mother Waddles at 313-WADDLES and tell them that you want to be one of Mother Waddles' elves. That number again is 313-WADDLES, or you can donate your car online at motherwaddles.org. And on behalf of the Mother Waddles mission, we wish everyone a very blessed holiday season.
Here's why I enjoy sports betting. It kind of gives you some skin in the game, as BetMGM likes to say.
You know you're a sports bettor when you're tuning in to watch a UConn football game. Chelsea Messenger and Michael Jenkins from the Daily Tip, presented by BetMGM.
It's some bad football, but if you have some skin in the game, all of a sudden you're invested in it, and then you look at the games from a different perspective.
All the insight you need to bet smarter is at BetQL.com. And listen to the Daily Tip, streaming weekday mornings from 6 to 9 Eastern on Odyssey.
Hi, I'm David Hall from Hall Financial. If you haven't refinanced your mortgage in 2021, you need to call Hall Financial right now to see if you qualify for the no appraisal 8-day close. 866-CALL-HALL, or you can chat with us online at callhallfirst.com.
This hour of instant feedback brought to you by Mike Papara of National Benefit Plans. For affordable health insurance, call 877-734-2200.
Last year, 97.1 The Ticket Student Heart Check Program detected over 150 student athletes who needed a follow-up with a cardiologist to ensure they have a healthy heart. Make time to have your child checked. Contact the Ernst Cardiovascular Center at Beaumont Hospital in Royal Oak. WXYT FM and WXYT HD1 Detroit. An Odyssey station. Sports headlines all day, every day. From the Sold by Mike Z Sports Desk. This is 97.1 The Ticket.
We're brought to you by Mother Waddles. No Pistons game in Chicago tomorrow night has been canceled due to a COVID outbreak among the Bulls. The Bulls game Thursday also postponed. Yesterday, Piston legend Dave Bing won one of the NBA's top 75 all-time player said he believes Cade Cunningham will be an all-star, but is not a player to build around. He also said they still need a point guard. Red Wings' Tyler Bertuzzi says even after suffering from COVID, he still will not get the vaccine and still will not be eligible to play in Canada. Lions, Cardinals, Sunday at Ford Field. Arizona favored by 14. They're playing tonight against the Rams. Cards favored by 2.5. You can hear it on the Bet 1270. Lions review at 7 p.m. tonight right here on the Ticket. AP All-America team is out. Two from Michigan. Michigan's Aiden Hutchinson and Jake Moody make the team, along with MSU's Kenneth Walker III. And we don't know if Kenneth Walker III will be playing in the Peach Bowl. This according to head coach Mel Tucker. At the Ticket Update Desk, I'm Jeff Lesson. For more, 97.1 The Ticket or Odyssey.com.
Shook hands with Santa Claus. If you want some candy, I'll bring you the candy. Shake hands with Santa Claus.
Question, and I don't mean to hijack the proceedings here, and we'll get to a college football issue. Is anybody... Please stop me if I'm overreacting. Are we getting a little concerned about sports? You hear these updates now. They're happening a little more and more. Like, it's almost like college football found the cure for COVID because it just was a non-issue. But now, Lions had a COVID outbreak. You got guys added to the COVID list tonight for tonight's game. You got cancellations in the NHL. You've got an NBA game being postponed. I'm not being an alarmist. I'm asking a question that as we head towards the NFL playoffs, is this going to be a thing again now?
See, here's the thing. I don't think college football found the cure.
I was about to say,
they don't have to say why a player is sitting out.
Right.
So where other sports have to definitely tell you it was COVID related, they could just say,
yeah,
illness.
But like as a sports fan, this has nothing to do with policy. It has nothing to do with vaccines. It has nothing to do with any issues that should upset some of you. This is just about, as a fan, have you noticed, like, it's a thing again?
Mike, as a fan, it ranks right up there with, did my favorite player get arrested? Did something happen? It's the new age of sports, where it used to be, hey, this guy rolled an ankle. Cade Cunningham rolled an ankle. Now it's just like, oh, so-and-so right. Got pulled over for a DUI, domestic assault.
Well, there was some conversation. There was some conversation briefly this weekend that the Lions game could be moved to Monday. They were missing that many people. And that just seemed so foreign, even though it was only a year ago. You just thought you were past it.
Yeah, the Pittsburgh, the 3 p.m. game.
On a Wednesday. Yeah, whatever it was. It was crazy. But, I mean, David, like, we sit here, and I know Kenny's all hot and bothered on the Tyler Bertuzzi thing. I really don't want to go down that road. It's more NHL game tonight, canceled. Basketball game in the NBA tomorrow, canceled. Multiple players missing from multiple teams this week in the NFL. Is this a thing again?
It seems like a thing again. The Washington football team just put a player on there now as you brought this up. Look. I understand it seems like a thing right now, and don't take this for some political statement or anything.
Oh, God,
but
please don't do this. We're all having fun.
I am treating this like it's the flu. You get a team that gets sick, they get through, it goes through the locker room, and then you just
play. I think that's the thing is now when you do get sick, it's okay. Before, you would just push through. It's why last week I'm like, yeah, I gotta do it from home.
Yeah,
and Mike was like, yeah, you're done. You're not even going to do a Friday show.
You know? Well, you sounded horrible. Let me tell you, hold on. I didn't mean it like that. I just meant, like, you sounded sick. And I'm like, bro, it's okay. You don't need to, you know, Spartacus. It's all right. Just take a nap. I'll do the Friday show.
But I think, you know, it's you still have that mentality. You know, you get around your fellas and you want to play for the team. You get everybody sick.
NFL
now.
Playoffs coming up.
Yeah.
Do you think we'll see guys missing games? Or do you think the league just goes into the submarine and is like, we're going to roll through this?
I'm asking.
I think it depends on how sick or who.
Yeah.
But Aaron Rodgers won't make the bench. But a top player.
I mean, you know.
Right. A top player. Or, you know what? look, you got a lot of, you know, the Dallas Cowboys is minus Zeke, and they're minus, you know,
that's Dak. What I'm saying.
Yeah.
I guess for me,
at the light, turn right onto Orchard Lake Road.
Surprised, and I'm guilty of, you know, look, everybody made their choice. You do what you do. You know, I went one way, other people went another. That's fine. I'm surprised I'm seeing games canceled. And whether it's this new Omicron variant, whether it is something else, I don't know. I can't explain why Michigan is somehow the league leader in all the wrong categories. I can't explain it. But I also, yeah, I was surprised when Kenny came on the air today and was like, yeah, game in the NHL tonight, canceled. Or when I heard that update, oh, Bulls, the NBA game, canceled.
Well, when it's that many people, you saw right. with the Lions, it was...
Lions game almost moved to Monday night.
Everybody on the practice squad, come into the main building because you're playing this week. Because we have nothing.
248-539-9797. And again, this isn't about policy. This isn't about vaccines. This is about none of it. It's not even about what you do and don't believe. This is just about, as a sports fan, are you surprised that it seems to be a thing?
I am surprised with the cancellations. That I am surprised with, because this is the first one in the NBA.
Right. So I'm not crazy for being surprised. No. And then, look, I apologize by ambushing you guys, but it was just a thought during the update. I'm like, is this what we're going to be doing again?
See, and Kenny's going to be upset with this statement, but the NHL is what it is, okay? They've canceled games already this season because it is. I don't care about the NHL. The minute it starts hitting something that I care about,
like the NBA and NFL.
And the NFL, then I'm like, okay, I did question, but I'm like, you know what? I was talking with Rico before the show.
Go past this light, then at the next one, turn left.
Well, that's the distance on roster.
I'm talking about the Bulls, but you're right.
No, but yeah, you bring up the G League players, send them in a separate hotel room and say, guys, we may need you to play in this game. We're not going to have you mingle with the main players just in case. But yeah, that's what you got a G League for.
Yeah.
If you have to, play the game, here's your shot.
And the NFL thing is the one, like, who got put on the COVID list for tonight's game?
Jalen Ramsey and Tyler Higbee.
Yeah. Okay, so two of the Rams' top 10 players out tonight, COVID. Might be a little bit of a stretch, but I like Higbee. I think he's a really, really good young tight end. No, he's not George Kittle, but he's a nice player. My point is, those are two studs not playing tonight.
Right.
Washington just popped somebody on the COVID list.
Jonathan Allen.
Okay.
Yep.
Another big-time player. Giants. Wait, I'm just kidding. I don't have a football team. The Lions had a huge COVID outbreak.
4.9 miles. Like, at the roundabout, take the second exit onto North Pontiac Trail.
I don't think it ever went away.
Okay. Guilty as charged. Because
I think we wanted it to go away, but I don't think it ever went away. And now I think you're seeing it in mass doses where teams are just, yeah, we can.
Yeah.
Because it would be like, yeah, we got a couple of players.
Right.
Yeah, we got eight. Your NBA team, you got eight players. You're not playing this game.
248-539-9797. Pick up the phone and start dialing. And again, there's nothing to argue about. There's nothing to get angry about. It's just when you're listening to the ticket and you hear about a couple of the Rams' best guys hitting the COVID list. Lions game, there was a discussion about moving it to Monday night because you didn't have enough players. Whether it be, you know, the NBA canceling a game tonight, the NHL canceling a game tonight. I just, you know what? For a segment or two in a four-hour radio show, I don't think it's the worst question to ask. Hey, guys, as sports fans, are we blindsided by this? Is this what you expected? And what are we looking at here the next 6 to 8 weeks? I don't know. 248-539-9797.
I think at that point, you just go back to, I don't know, maybe you go to stronger mask policies in the building. Make sure.
No, I'm just saying, make sure you can play.
Did you see?
see that one? The one across the street from that. I talked to Christine about it. It's like, we did the curb, and there's like a major sinkhole. And like, I mean, it's 3 feet deep. Yeah. It's in the job. I think it was 3077. Lotworth. It's right across the street from that guy. Ask Christine. I sent her all the info.
getting real
$12 million dollars, you could shoot me up with laced crack.
Really?
I would take my chances.
$12 million, you'd do crack.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Dude, for $12 million, I wouldn't have to do this no more.
You'd be addicted.
Maybe. But then I'd have the money to get a pass.
Did you see on that Whitney Houston crack?
I don't know. I'm just saying, for $12 million, I ain't giving away $12 million over a needle. I don't care what I believe. Here's my beliefs. I want $12 million. Fine. I don't even know what that does to you.
Roberto, though.
Hey, Roberto, $12 million. Forget it. Right. You do it for 12 cents. Well, we've been working together too long.
I thought somebody was going to say $12.
He doesn't have that kind of integrity. All right, what do you have? And then we'll go to the people.
I'm getting real worried as a Michigan fan. I can come see December 31st, Hutchinson, Haskins, McNamara out.
COVID. No.
Oh, you mean for COVID?
Yeah.
Well, I thought you meant opting out.
No, not for the playoffs. No.
But as a fan, that would concern you if you're worried about sports.
Yeah. It is what you hold your breath, because every time you hear breaking news, athlete does something, you're like, please not my guy. Please not my guy. Okay. Wasn't my team. So that's, I equate it to that now. When you hear there's a player on the COVID list, you hold your breath and say, okay.
No, now tonight, no Ramsey, no Higby.
COVID.
Big impact on tonight's game. Cancellation in the NBA, cancellation in the NHL.
David, go ahead.
All right.
It's winter time. The normal increase in sickness happens. So, yes, it does concern me that it will affect sports.
Okay. Go to Dave. Fine. Howdy, so do I. What's up, Dave?
Hey, guys. Cunningham, for me, is already the best player on the team.
Amen.
He's played like it. Huh?
Think.
with that?
100%.
And we need to get whatever we can for Grant. I don't care if it's a bag of chips. Would you say Grant maybe is a top 40 player, but you're not going anywhere with him? So I would like them. I know he's hurt right now, but if they can treat him.